الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر.
To continue what we started in the previous khutbah about the heedlessness or the state of heedlessness of ghafla. When people get back away from the right way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for certain reasons, we mentioned some of them in the previous khutbah, and we promised to talk about the treatment in this khutbah insha'Allah. And here we fulfill insha'Allah some of the reminders that we learned from the Quran and the Sunnah and the sayings of our scholars, how to get out of a state of ghafla, how to get rid of ghafla, how to end this situation of heedlessness. The first step to end the state of ghafla is to know that there is ghafla. Many people who are sick, they carry the disease, if they don't feel, if they don't recognize that they are sick, they may die. Like a person who is locked in his house and he is not able to smell and there is gas leak. What's expected to happen? He will die. He didn't smell the danger. He didn't feel it. So first thing, we should know that there is a state of ghafla. But what are the symptoms of the disease? Number one, laziness regarding ta'a, regarding the acts of worship, the good deeds, very lazy. When it comes to salah, when he wakes up, hardly to wake up. When he stands for the salah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes that those who are lazy regarding salah, those are the hypocrites. The Quran said that إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ. And then Allah describes them when they get up for prayer, وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسِ. When they stand up, when they get up for prayer, they get up very lazy, with laziness, just showing off that they are praying. So be aware of that. Avoid at the time of prayer to wake up with laziness, but go get up fresh and active for salah, longing for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the way of the believers. الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَاجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. They are not only getting up for salah, they are waiting in for salah in most cases, as we'll describe it inshallah. So very lazy in ta'a. But if it's a matter of dunya, inshallah, you see him in the markets shopping for hours. 4 hours shopping and no problem with him. At work, standing, ready to carry like lots of stuff and put lots of stuff. When it comes to prayer, tired. He may run for 1 hour or even more in the morning at 5 a.m. But when it comes to the salah, no. This is a state of ghafla. What else from the symptoms? To belittle the sins. He commits sins, and when you ask him, he says, this is sagha'ir, that's minor sins. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud mentioned that a believer would see his sins like a mountain that would fall upon him. While the wicked person, amma al-fajr, he sees his sins just like a fly, came to his nose and did like this. That's very easy. He doesn't care about the sins he's committing. We request our brothers holding their phones, please pay attention to the khutbah, because it removes the ajr for your khutbah. Please put your phones down. Jazakumullah. So, when it comes to the ta'ah, they are lazy. When it comes to the sins, they belittle them. And we express, we mention the dalil that shows you the difference between a believer and the fajr, the rebellious one. Also, from the signs of ghafla, he feels familiar with the sins. He even committing the sins normally. He even could do it in public. Like the one who doesn't care if he smokes in public, if he talks to girls in public, if he commits the sins in public, he doesn't feel ashamed of his sins. This is a sign of ghafla as well. From the signs and symptoms of ghafla, wasting lots of times in no benefit, in nonsense. As we mentioned, hurt his root by spending long times doing nothing beneficial either to his deen or his dunya. Just wasting the time. This is a state of ghafla. While the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded the ummah to make the best use of their life, of their efforts, of their energy. اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Use five things or make the best use of five things before other five things come. What are those five things, Ya Rasulallah? شبابك قبل هرمك. Your young age before becoming old. The youth, they should use the treasure of their life, this age, when he's young, when he's strong. شبابك قبل هرمك. وصحتك قبل سقمك. Your health before becoming sick. وغناك قبل فقرك. Your richness before becoming poor. وحياتك قبل موتك. And your life before your death. And before it, وفراغك قبل شغلك. Your free time before you get too busy. So make the best use of your young age. Make the best use of your health. Make the best use of your free time. Make the best use of your life. To use all of it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the first things to do, to recognize that there is a disease called the ghafla that affects us. Then the second step, to learn about your deen. Yes, you learn a lot to get your bachelor's or getting your master's, to get your PhD. That's good regarding the dunya. But you are requested to keep learning about your deen all your life. Don't be satisfied with what you learned at young age. You were 7 or 8 or 9. Some people, their knowledge about deen ended at 12 years old. His salah is just the salah his parents taught him. He didn't learn after that. When you ask them about some basic rulings of deen, they don't know about it. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't command his prophet to ask for extra, to ask for increase from anything except knowledge. He said to him, وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. And say, my Lord, increase my knowledge. Because with your knowledge, you will worship Allah in the best way. The difference between a person of knowledge and the person who doesn't have knowledge, like the difference between a prophet and the least one of the people around him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he said in the hadith. When you start with this intention to seek the knowledge of deen, when you start seeking the knowledge of deen, you should know that Allah wants to do good for you. Hadith Muawiyah, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا. Allah wants to do good for you. You faqihu fi deen. He would let him learn about the deen. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا يَلْجَنَّةً. Whoever starts
the way, the road to seek the knowledge, Allah made it easy for him, a way to, the way to paradise. So he's on the right way leading to Jannah, because he will worship Allah with knowledge. And big difference in ibadah of the person who has knowledge and the person who has nothing. So seek the knowledge for the sake of Allah. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, "Ad-dunya mal'una, mal'un kullu ma fiha." This world life is a cursed, cursed life, and everything in it is cursed except the remembrance of Allah. Illa dhikrullah wa alim wa mutaallim. Except for the remembrance of Allah and whatever related to it, and a knowledgeable person and a seeker of knowledge. So either to be remembered or seeker of knowledge or teacher of knowledge. But don't accept for yourself to be sabahlala. Umar ibn Khattab, he said, Allah doesn't like to see someone who is sabahlala, doing the nonsense. Trivial person, doesn't, not busy doing something related to dunya or deen. Many people living this life these days like this, living for nothing, doing nothing, and this is a state of ghafla, condemned in our deen. The third treatment for the ghafla, the remembrance of Allah. Believe it, wallahi, this remembrance, when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it gives you strength in your heart, in your deen, and even in your body. Those people who experience the real remembrance, they would find energy in their body because of the remembrance of Allah. Whether tahleel, la ilaha illallah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, or istighfar, whatever kind of remembrance you're doing or reciting Quran, it gives you the power from like inside and even physical power in your body. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba, should I tell you about something which is the best of your good deeds, خير أعمالكم, and the most purified on the side of your Lord, وأزكاها عند مليككم وأرفعها في درجاتكم, the highest with which you did the highest ranks. He said, what's that, Ya Rasulullah? He said, even وَخَيْرُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِنْفَاقِ الْوَرِقِ وَالذَّهَبِ, even better than spending, donating gold and silver, better than fighting in the cause of Allah, meeting your enemies, and they're killing you and you're killing them. وَخَيْرُ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْ تَلْقَوْا عَدُوَّكُمْ فَيَضْرِبُوا رِقَابَكُمْ وَتَضْرِبُوا رِقَابَهُمْ. What's that, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah. But the believer who reads the Quran and the Sunnah, he would recognize that in many verses, when Allah commands us to remember, He mentioned the word كَثِيرًا, a lot. Not just once or twice or a couple of times in my day or in my week or just during the month of Ramadan. No, كثيرا, all the time, many times. His tongue is wasted with the remembrance of Allah. Like the Sahabi, he came to the Prophet complaining, Ya Rasulullah, there are a lot of good deeds in the deen now. Guide me to the best thing I can do, he said. لا يزال لسانك رطب بذكر الله. Keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep your tongue remembering. This is the easiest. It doesn't need wudu. You can remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on any situation you are in, whether having wudu or not. Okay. To remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remove the ghafla, to be living real life. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ كَمَثَلِ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The example of the one who remembers Allah, the one who doesn't, like the living and dead. And you choose for yourself whether you are living or dead. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. He invites you to what gives you life.
The real life
of the heart of a believer with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In all situations, every time. Also from the treatments of the ghafla to attend the gathering of remembrance, like this khutbah. Like the halaqa in which we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or seeking knowledge together. Like the gathering where people recite Quran. These blessed gatherings when the angels would come down to them, revolving around them. When the rahmah descend upon them. When Allah mentions us in the lofty company of them, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is connected. That happens when you remember Allah. That happens when you remember Allah and you gathered with people seeking knowledge. There is more barakah than the one who's just watching some videos and learning from them. The barakah when it's life in the masjid, the house of Allah. You are in the house of the most generous one. What do you expect? He will honor you. He will show you the real hospitality. When you come to his house, you will never get deprived from the khair. And you spend some time in the masajid, gathering with people, encouraging each other to remember Allah. In the hadith, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. When you pass by the gardens of paradise, take your share from them. What are رياض الجنة حلق الذكر, the circles of remembrance. The Prophet ﷺ commands us, when you find them, go and join them. The angels would gather with the people remembering Allah upon each other until they reach the sky. Allah asks them, how did you find the right servants? Then they tell him, he found them remembering you, Allah. And there is a beautiful saying in the hadith. At the end of it, Allah says, أُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. Witness that I have forgiven all of them. One of the angels would say, Ya Allah, there is one amongst them, he didn't come for the remembrance. He came for some other purpose. He said, those people, whoever is related to them, whoever joins them, will never suffer. All of them forgiven. Even the one who attended for another purpose other than remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That would be a remover and treatment for the ghaflah. قول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله.
الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove the ghaflah away from our hearts. Make us amongst those who make the best use of their lives and their times, Ya Allah. The best cure, the best treatment for the state of ghaflah ever for your heart, reciting the Quran. Reciting more and more from the verses of the Quran. Because Al-Quran shifa, cure for us. In the Quran, you'll find two things Allah mentioned them as shifa. Al-Quran and the honey of the bees. Our scholars said Al-Quran is a treatment for inside. And the honey is a treatment or physical treatment for the bodies. So the treatment of your soul is the Quran. And the treatment of your body is using the honey. يخرج من بطونها شراب مختلف ألوانه فيه شفاء للناس. This regarding the honey. Treatment for the sickness. And for the Quran, he said, وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين ولا يزيد الظالمين. Quran is a cure for the believers. قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هدى وشفاء. For the believer, it's a guidance and treatment.
يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور.
That's why الإمام ابن القيم he says, فبالجملة لا شيء أنفع للقلب من قراءة القرآن.
Generally speaking, nothing would benefit your heart like the Quran. It's the best of remembrance. أفضل الذكر. Reciting the Quran, because it teaches you a khawf, fear from Allah, والرجاء, hope from Allah. Teaches you the tawakkul, teaches you patience, teaches you the manners that would help your heart to survive on ta'ah.
خباب بن الأرت, he said something interesting. قال تقرب إلى الله ما استطعت.
Get closer to Allah with whatever good deeds you can do. You will never get closer to Him with something that would be dearer to Him than His own speech, Al-Quran al-Karim. فلن تتقرب إليه بشيء أحب إليه من كلامه.
وكان عثمان رضي الله عنه يقول لو صحت قلوبكم.
If you have sound hearts, you will never feel full from the speech of your Lord, the Quran.
لو صحت قلوبكم ما شبعتم من كلام ربكم. كان عبد الله ابن مسعود يقول من أحب القرآن أحب الله ورسوله.
Whoever loves the Quran is the person who loves Allah and His Messenger. So the Quran is the best treatment for the ghafla, the state of heedlessness. And the more you recite from it, the more you get rid of the state.
We'll stop at this inshallah because of the time passing. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to revive our hearts with Iman. Revive our hearts with Quran and guide us to the way that leads of Jannah al-Rahman. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. ربنا لا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته. لا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها خير إلا قضيتها ويسرتها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة نعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم أحي قلوبنا بالقرآن. اللهم زين الإيمان في قلوبنا. اللهم زين الإيمان في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. نعوذ بك من الغفلة والنسيان برحمتك يا حنان يا منان. اللهم إنا نسألك نصرة لأهلنا وإخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصرهم على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تحقن دماء إخواننا في غزة وفي فلسطين. اللهم احفظهم بحفظك يا كريم وانصرهم بنصرك يا أرحم الراحمين. وانصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم استعملنا لنصرة دينك يا كريم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الغفلة عن إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الغفلة عن إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصرنا وإياهم على القوم الكافرين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.